In this video, we will demonstrate how to install the LCN 1460 series door closer and perform initial adjustments. After watching this video, you will be able to locate and drill the mounting hole locations in your door and frame, install the closer and closer arms, and adjust the closer for proper operation. These are the tools you will need. When ordered in one of its most common configurations, the 1460 series, also referred to by its model number, 1461, can be installed in three different ways. On the hinge side, the closer can be installed on the door with a regular arm. This is known as pull side mount. On the non-hinge side, the closer can be installed on the door with a parallel arm, known as push side mount, or on the frame with a regular arm, known as top jam mount. These mounting options have different drilling locations in the door and frame. Therefore, it is very important to ensure that you know how it should be installed. The hardware schedule is a document that describes what closer should be installed and in what configuration. Check the hardware schedule for your opening and look for any notes that might describe the installation method. Also, look on the schedule for other hardware that will be installed on the door or frame, such as a coordinator or overhead holder, as these may require a special prep template. This video demonstrates how to install the 1460 closer on the inside of the door, pull side mount, with a regular arm. For all other mounting and arm options, please see the instruction sheet. Ensure the door swings freely, fits into the frame without binding, and that any latching hardware engages easily. There should be a 1/8-inch gap on the top and sides between the door and frame. The included paper templates can be used to determine the drilling locations for all mounting options. The template should only be used on doors with butt-type hinges. If your door has pivots or swing-clear hinges, contact your door hardware supplier for help. Determine the handing of the door. In this video, the door is left-hand. Please note the installation instructions show a right-hand door. The steps to install are the same. Fold and tear the template along the dotted line, separating into a piece for the forearm that will mount on the frame, and a piece for the closer that will mount on the door. Identify the side of each piece that matches your door application. If the template cannot be used, the installation instructions provide the dimensions to mark and measure the hole locations. Next, determine how far the door opens. In this video, the door opens to 90 degrees. The 1460 has two possible pull side mounting locations, one for doors that open up to 110 degrees, and another for doors that open up to 180 degrees. The template must be fixed on the door in a specific location based on the degree of opening. For doors that open up to 180 degrees, the template can be aligned directly on the door and frame edges. For doors that open up to 110 degrees, the closer and forearm templates must be placed 3 inches away from the door and frame edges. Use a tape measure to make a mark on the door 3 inches from the hinge edge. And use the T-square to extend that mark onto the frame. Remove the adhesive backing from the door template piece. Then apply the template to the door, aligning with the 3-inch mark as shown. Remove the adhesive backing from the frame template piece. Then, apply the template to the frame, aligning with the 3-inch mark as shown. Use the center punch to mark the 4 drill locations on the door and the 2 drill locations on the frame. Remove the template from the door and frame. Drill 1/8-inch pilot holes at all locations. Use a screwdriver to carefully remove the cover from the closer as shown. The spring power setting on the closer must be adjusted to provide proper closing force for your door. Please note, an improperly adjusted spring may result in personal injury or property damage. measure the width of your door. Then, using the chart in the installation instructions, determine the spring power setting based on your door width. Adjust the spring to the correct number using the 5/32 inch hex wrench. Turn the screw until the proper number appears in the power window. Install the bracket on the door as shown, and secure with the two screws. Self-reaming, self-tapping screws are provided as standard. Depending on your application, your supplier may have also provided wood screws or through bolts and machine screws. We recommend using wood screws for wood doors. If you are using wood screws, you may need to drill a larger pilot hole to match the screw size and avoid splitting the wood. If a power tool will be used, lower the clutch setting to avoid over-tightening, which may strip the heads in the door or the frame. The use of an impact driver is not recommended. Install the forearm on the frame, with the longer side pointing to the hinges as shown. Secure with the two screws. Slide the closer body onto the bracket as shown. Align the other end of the closer with the holes drilled in the door, and secure with the two screws. Slide the arm tube over the rod and attach the arm to the closer, ensuring that the notch on the pinion aligns with the arm as shown in the diagram from the installation instructions. Secure with the screw. Thread the arm screw through the tube and into the rod. Position the arm at 90 degrees. Then, tighten the arm screw with the 5/32 inch hex wrench. Making adjustments to the closer allows you to control the motion of your door. There are three adjustments: backcheck, main speed, and latch speed. The closer comes from the factory, adjusted for a typical opening. Your closer may need additional adjustments depending on your installation requirements. Before making any adjustments, cycle the door twice to observe its operation. On a left-hand door, the adjustment screws will be located on the bottom. Please note, do not back out the adjustment screws too far. If you are close to backing out the screw completely, you should feel increased resistance. Once you feel this resistance, do not back the screw out any further. The back check adjustment changes the amount of resistance you feel as you open the door. It starts to take effect at about 70 degrees. The purpose is to reduce wear on the door, wall, and hinges. Please note that backcheck does not serve as a doorstop. To adjust it, locate the backcheck screw, which is the screw closest to the spring tube. For more backcheck, turn the screw 1/4 turn clockwise with the 3/32 inch hex wrench, and cycle the door twice to test. For less backcheck, turn the screw 1/4 turn counterclockwise and test. The next two adjustments are main speed and latch speed. The main speed controls the speed of the door as it closes from fully open to about 20 degrees. The latch speed is the speed at which the door closes during the last 20 degrees. The goal for these two adjustments is to allow the door to close in a controlled manner and latch quietly. The door should not slam. When changing these two closing speed adjustments, remember the Americans with Disabilities Act requires doors to take, at minimum, 3 seconds to close from 70 degrees to within 3 inches of the latch. Locate the main speed screw, which is closest to the pinion, where the arm is attached to the body. Make an adjustment 1/4 turn at a time. Counterclockwise to increase speed, and clockwise to decrease speed. Then, open the door and release it to observe the closing speed. The latch speed screw is adjacent to the main speed screw. Make an adjustment 1/4 turn at a time. Counterclockwise to increase speed, and clockwise to decrease speed. Then, open the door all the way and release it to observe the latching speed. If the door still will not latch, increasing the spring power half a number at a time can provide additional closing force. However, increasing the spring power will require more force to open the door. To complete the installation, snap the closer cover into place and attach the shaft cap to the underside of the closer, as shown. For assistance, contact customer care at 877-671-7011.